Microlecture 31, Origins and Causes of World War I. There are many arguments about the origins and causes of World War I. The debates about what happened began right after the war started and continue today. We can safely argue that the conflict's origins can be found in the 19th century and the immediate causes in the few years before the start of the war in 1914. One of the leading causes of World War I was nationalism. Together with militarism, nationalism promoted national security concerns, economic debates, welfare crisis, identity confrontation, and overseas empires competition that triggered conflicts between nations, alliances, and empires in Europe. Competition between nations intensified greatly when Germany became a unified nation-state and Europe's most powerful country in 1871, as Chancellor Bismarck was consolidating his power and claiming that Germany was a quote-unquote satisfied power, desiring only peace, a new era in international relations began. Bismarck's idea of preserving peace was to keep rival France isolated and without military allies. His second main concern was not getting caught in the middle of the conflict between two rival empires, Austria-Hungary and Russia. Both of these powerful political entities were competing for the territories formerly part of the declining Ottoman Empire. To achieve this, Bismarck broke a series of treaties and alliances, all meant to ensure the balance of power in Europe and prevent the outbreak of war. In 1890, a new emperor in Germany named Wilhelm II forced Bismarck to resign and jeopardize Europe's stability. Wilhelm broke Germany's alliance with Russia and forced them to sign a Franco-Russian alliance in 1892. With France and Russia now allied against Germany, Austria and Italy, Great Britain's foreign policy became increasingly crucial. Many Germans and some Britons felt that the ethnically related Germanic and Anglo-Saxon peoples were natural allies. However, the good relations between Prussia and Great Britain since the mid-18th century gave way after 1890 to a bitter Anglo-German rivalry. Several reasons explain the rivalry between Germany and Great Britain. First, both entities' commercial interests, since the Germans expressed their interest in building an overseas empire to compete with the British. The other reason is that German nationalism believed military power was essential to consolidate its role as a world power, something the British believed to be a menace. Acknowledging growing German power, the British leaders organized their own alliance and agreements. They improved their relations with the United States, concluded an alliance with Japan in 1902, and formed the Anglo-French Entente in 1904. In 1906, Germany demanded an international conference to challenge French control over Morocco. The conference failed, and Germany's attitude forced Britain and France closer together. The Moroccan crisis was something of a diplomatic revolution. Britain, France, Russia, and even the United States began to view Germany as a potential threat. At the same time, German leaders began to suspect sinister plots to encircle Germany and block its development as a world power. In 1907, Russia and Britain settled their outstanding differences and signed the Anglo-Russian Agreement, together with the earlier Franco-Russian Alliance of 1892 and Anglo-French Entente of 1904. This treaty catalyzed the Triple Entente, the alliance of Great Britain, France, and Russia in the First World War. By 1909, Europe's leading nations were divided in two hostile blocs, both prepared to fight and looking for an excuse to do it. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.